the homestay's interior. This evening we are in DLF Western Heights, and this house belongs to Mr. Rajshekar and Mr. Salwa. And today we are there in the dining area. I want to explain the dining area first. It's a combination of the foyer, the living and the dining. We have partitioned the foyer and the dining area with a tree of life concept. It's made of MDF, it's laser cut, and it's nicely decorated with a half white color. And then coming to the living room, we basically played with 3-4 colors in this room, like the golden wood color, then the caramel color, beige color, and the TV back wall is completely made with a wave board, and it is painted using metallic shining colors, like multicolor concept. So the foyer is nicely designed using a very beautiful light, which is lit up with a tree hanging lights, and then the tree of life concept. And then we have the shoerack, which is like very minimal, and it nicely fits the entire foyer space. The wallpaper here, which is used on the back side of the sofa wall, it also has all the colors that we have used in the room. The caramel color is really looking good, and it entirely highlights the wallpaper and the background of the entire back side of the sofa wall. Also, we have lit it at the corner with a very beautiful bulb. It's a very cute bulb, and then it just gives a very cozy and neat look to the corner of this living room. And then the drapes, and then coming to the TV unit section. The TV unit is a huge TV unit. We have made it as simple as possible so that the other features that we have used in this TV unit gets highlighted, like this wave board with multicolor paint, and then the very tiny showcase. And then we have a beautiful storage cabinet which can accommodate the Xbox, the home theater, and then all the setup box and whatever gadgets the client is having. Then coming to the dining area of the house, the dining area of the house is slightly smaller in size. However, we made it look like really larger by glittering it up with a very big mirror on the background, and then a beautiful 3D painting, and then the whole room looks cozy with the wallpaper, the neatly done false ceiling. The false ceiling is also not really heavy. It's a very simple false ceiling with the rafter concepts, and then it's not the borders, but how the borders are made thicker, and then the whole look of the living room is really cozy and feels good. So many concepts are used, but all the concepts are used in a very lighter way. And coming to the next part of the house, the kitchen, the very beautiful section of the house. This kitchen is actually a small kitchen which is divided into a utility and a kitchen part. So what we have done is we have entirely removed the partition between the utility and the kitchen, and we have made it a one long kitchen. The tiles are also changed as per the look of the kitchen that we have got over here, as per the laminate colors, as per the backsplash and the quartz that we have given over the countertop. The kitchen is completely inbuilt, and then we have the OTG down at the bottom of the kitchen cabinets, the microwave, the inbuilt hob appliances, and then an inbuilt dishwasher, which is nicely accommodated in the parallel kitchen in a well mannered way. The backsplash is also chosen with a deep thinking and lot of effort on this. It doesn't look like a regular backsplash that you generally see. We've got multiple colors in the backsplash on the white, which really makes the kitchen look larger and very beautiful. So the kitchen is, we have used a different color combination, like it's not gray or silver, it's very like passokai-like kind of color, and then a rustic white, which gels with the entire concept of the kitchen. So we have used profile handles to make it look very sleek and simple. and a very nice area for the fridge. So the kitchen looks really fantastic with all these color combinations. And coming to the next part of the room, we are, this is the lobby. The lobby is generally designed for multiple reasons, like for showcase and for many other purposes. But in this house, we have designed this lobby entirely as a storage area. So this is a complete storage cabinet with four-door sliding. We used a 4-inch anti-scratch. It's a completely anti-scratch glass laminate, and then we have used a complete golden wooden shade at the bottom to continue the concept of the entire living room to the lobby area. And walking inside the guest room, again the guest room is really simple. However, we have used different color combinations in the guest room. Like the guest room has also accommodated, we have accommodated the puja mandir. Though the area of the room is slightly smaller in size, we have tried to accommodate a very cute wardrobe, a study table, and then the puja cabinet. Also, we got the puja cabinet size to be really smaller in size, whereas we made it really cute looking with a very good pattern on the glasses, the Ganesha which is on the L shape, all different types of motifs on the glass, and then one side there is a belt, and there is a seated aspect when elders sit and do puja. They have a seated down, they can pull it and sit and do the puja. And then coming to the wardrobe section, we have made the wardrobe with two different colors, also three different colors, like the white which is really glittering, and then with the yellow and the blue combination, which is totally different combination. And the handles, if you look at it, it's a different type of handle which is well accommodated, and it's suiting the entire look of the wardrobe. And then the painting, the fans, and every single thing that we've used in this room is like well accommodated, well blending with the entire theme of the room. And then coming to the next part of the house, the children would really like to have a look at this room. This is the children bedroom of this house. Generally, the children bedroom of the house is always in a flashy colors like blues and pinks and yellows. However, in this house, the client is very particular about colors which really do not become flashy to the house. They want all subtle, simple colors. So according to them, we have designed this room using a raw wood color, which is like very nice wood color, which is a gray and blue mixed wood on the loft. And then coming to the wardrobe phase, you can see a very nice beige color with a peacock blue on that. So this gives a very elegant look to the wardrobe. And then if you look at the bunker bed is completely made of teak wood, and the concept that's used in the bunker bed is also matching with the entire theme of the room. And next to the bunker bed, a small bookshelf that is designed for the children to keep their books. And then when you look at the ceiling is made of clouds. So the child really loved it, and they say it saw the clouds on the ceiling. And then again, we have made a little study cabinet only for a reading purpose. And then the whole children room looks very simple. At the same time, all needs are accommodated in the room. The curtains, the wall colors, everything blends well with the concept of the room. And coming to the final part of this video, that's the master bedroom of the house. The master bedroom of the house is another concept that we have made in this in this house. That is a very different concept of golden, the charcoal boards, the laminates, everything blended well with the sliding water here. And then we have the dressing unit, which is also carrying the same concept of the wardrobe. And then a very well neatly designed designed bed. We've used a PU bed headboard, and then the false ceiling, the paint colors, the fans, the lights, the everything that's used in this room are like well matching with the entire theme of this house. So hope you all like the video. The house concepts are really different when compared to the earlier videos you have seen. And then thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day. If you like the video, please log on to www.homescaseinterior.com. Thank you.